So I was saying that Labor Day, 2015. My baby cooked a delicious lunch for us.
We needed to eat. Would you pass that syrup over here, baby? Thanks.
This is damn delicious, but I was gonna say, do you know what's so damn funny about us?
What, baby?
Well, a whole lot, but can you name one thing that's so fucking hilarious about us?
Our unfailing optimism.
That's true. That's hilarious because we have absolutely no reason to be optimistic, and basically we're not. We know we're doomed from the damn beginning. And the only thing that might happen is the damn universe steps in. It's just like, yeah, Luke Skywalker found his way to that Achilles heel.
Right.
Why can't I say that? Achilles heel. Not Achilles heel. But anyway, he shot that vulnerable place. Sorry. Delicious sausage, babe.
Thank you, baby.
I can't remember what I was saying.
Luke Skywalker found the Achilles heel, probably on the Death Star.
The Death Star, that vulnerable spot on the Death Star, and he shot it. I'm sorry for laughing, but everything sounds so funny because we're funny. I mean, okay, what did he have going for him? Because it's like, he's not that damn skilled. He's just a fucking wannabe Jedi. He grew up on a fucking farm. Out in the middle of Tatooine. I mean, he don't know shit from apple butter kind of thing, you know? It's like,
well, he had the Force.
Well, okay, he had the Force, but he wasn't all that good at it. He was kind of a dope with it. He was constantly making stupid mistakes and kept trying, but kind of failing, you know, along the way. But
totally.
But what did he have? First of all, he had damn Han Solo and all those other the rest of the crew. He had some help. He didn't do it all by himself.
All his friends were criminals.
Yeah, because it's criminal to be the good guy in the world.
To be a rebel.
Plus, Han Solo killed somebody.
That's weird. Rebel is actually a name everyone could agree on. The rebels and the persecutors. You know?
Except for one problem, honey. The South calls themselves the rebels. And I think they're rebellious, and I think they have a certain truth, you know, but they're fucking warped, honey. Those people are seriously crazy. I know I am one. I'm from the South. My people are Southern, and everybody damn knows that. By the way, I freaking talk. I'm a redneck. I know the redneck culture as well as any other fucking redneck. I just happen to know the academic culture too. I happen to be able to maneuver between both worlds rather gracefully.
Yeah, you do.
And so, a lot of times people in academia don't know I grew up a poor girl in Western Kansas and don't have a clue about the kind of, like, my crazy wild life experiences. Mm-hmm. Most people in school who are my classmates don't get that about me either. They see me and they see this normal white person. And that's their first damn mistake.
Hmm.
Ain't nothing if not normal. Wait, no, that's not it. I ain't nothing if not normal.
Not. Gotta get the right number or not, so. But that's very true.
But you're not normal either, and that's why we're such good friends. I mean, and that's why you're my husband, and that's why you've chosen to live a bizarro life with me, because most people aren't interested, honey, but people want to have normal lives. And that is something that I've never been able to understand, but I'm learning. It's true. They don't want to be rock stars. They don't want to be fucking on MTV. They don't want to be on MTV. Hmm. You know that song about MTV?
Yeah.
Will you sing it? Is it Dire Straits?
I should learn to play the guitar.
I should learn to play them drums. No. Banging on the bongo like a chimpanzee.
Right.
No. I want my MTV.
Mm. So, some people actually don't want that, is that what you're saying?
Right.
Hmm, okay.
I don't get it. Well, my point is, rednecks are often very oppressed and very left uneducated. I happen to be a very unique and strange redneck because I am highly educated, really. I have 4 degrees, all with high honors and stuff, highest honors, and all sorts of other academic achievements. But I think everybody knows when they look at me, I'm a damn redneck. I'm not Levon Helm, or I'm actually a blues singer, but I'm black. I'm a man. I'm older, and I got gray hair. And I'll tell you what, I'm a real kind of, the color of my skin is kind of golden brown, and with some ruddiness to it, because I've been around the damn block. I've been to war, man. I have survived the war. I was a fucking Black Panther in my youth. But now I'm just a really angry old black dude. So I understand the rednecks and the people who oppress them. People don't know that when I say I embody these people, I mean I embody them. I see it on the damn screen. Yeah. I physically embody that. I'm sitting out on my porch swing and I'm bitterly angry. But I know it's futile. I need to love my brother. And so I'm trying to use my anger and my bitterness to make the world a damn better place, but it's hopeless because the children won't listen. They're off running around chasing after drugs and sex and just straight up stupidity. I need a damn cane so I can knock it on the fucking floor. Yeah, I curse, but I go to church every Sunday. I get down on my knees and I pray for this world. I was there when Martin Luther King Jr. protested. I protested with him and I had my head beaten. And it was worth a couple teeth. Who needs them? in a world that'll take you and your wife and your children and fucking lynch them in the fucking front yard. A couple of teeth was an easy price to pay. And you all are telling me to break out of prison? Well, fuck you. That wasn't your prison. It was mine. And I judge all of you. You didn't have to live it, I did. But I'm still gonna help the fucking world. That's how complex I am. I've watched you kill my people. In their own front yards. I'm not even gonna go into the fucking details because you all know them even though you fucking deny them. Creep. Yeah, I learned that one from the young people. They're always teaching me newfangled language. I'm gonna use it because I need to talk to anybody who's gonna be willing to listen because this shit is beyond unacceptable. Look what is happening to my people. Well, that's why it's a little complex to live with me, right, babe? Mm-hmm. People cannot handle that shit. They will freak the fuck out and run away. I bet people are turning off the damn deal because they're like, who embodies another body like that? Well, I do. I guess I'm weird, but you do. And I needed you because you can do that, you know? But we're so damn different. You're a different embodiment and different embodiments. Which is good, because we can't be together if we don't have different bodies. And I don't mean gender-wise, I just mean different, separate. My baby's cool with it. I was saying that I'm a product of the patriarchy. Well, I should be. I'm a man. I care, Papa. I fucking care. But I ate all the sausage, Luna. Well, you've got steak, don't you? Yeah, you can have some in a minute. But I tell you what, Papa. I may care, but I don't have an ounce of beginnings to understand and comprehend Grandma. You're not the only one, Luna. One day I broke out into tears like that while I was performing an acting class, and everybody freaked the fuck out. Like, why? It's performance class. Aren't you going to perform, or are you going to pretend like you're yourself performing? There's always going to be a little of that because you are yourself performing, you know? But anyway, I've had them freak out, honey. My mom was a great actor. She used to act like she was this old lady at bedtime. Freaked us the fuck out and made us cry. We'd cry, "Bring back our mama! Bring back our mama!" She'd come back and she'd be laughing. She had a great sense of humor, and it was usually at our expense. But it was fun, because she was really good at that shit. So good at it that I just didn't know where my mom went.
That's cool.
Well, honey, you're the cool one, honey. My baby has been, like, a saint, you guys.
No, so, because my dad has been an angel.
A very complex angel, then. I'll give it that. I mean, I'm like Riddick, kind of like the anti-fucking hero. And
be the anti-angel, but you're still an angel.
Okay, cool. Yeah. I can handle that. I don't like the idea of a damn anti-hero. There are
people out there are gonna be like,
an anti-angel and it's a devil.
No, it's an anti-angel. It's Mac.
Well, that's what I'm saying, actually, that an anti-hero is the devil. But Riddick wasn't the devil.
No.
He was bad. That was why his goodness was so profound.
I'm glad that my baby thought he knew about Riddick. I think that's cool.
Riddick is cool. I mean, Pitch Black.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's all I've seen so far, but
we're trying to get the cross.
A plus. Mm, I mean,
my baby gave it A plus.
I could criticize it for its violence and putting children in peril, but it seemed very believable, really. And not too far out there, because you didn't get too attached to kids before the creatures
got them.
Well, because Riddick himself wasn't attached, you know. He stayed detached from shit. He knew he had to survive, and worrying about every fucking kid that walks past,
nah,
is not gonna make you survive. You're gonna... You try to save that kid, you're going out, because that kid's gonna be stupid. And they were.
Yeah. Those kids.
I felt sorry for that Indian dude. He lost all his kids.
His kids were like fish in a barrel, baby. It's there for the snatching.
I thought they were shooting them.
Whatever.
You know, shooting fish in a barrel.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
You know.
That's stupid.
What do they even mean by shooting, really?
I think they mean shooting them with a gun.
Why would you do that?
For sport.
That's dumb.
People are dumb.
So, oh gosh, I guess I always thought surely they mean something other than that, because the idea of shooting at fish in a barrel is so asinine.
Maybe it's a...
Actually imagine anyone doing it, but no, I think you're
haven't
right.
Haven't you seen damn westerns where they shoot fish in a damn barrel? I don't know if I have, but I can see it in my mind's eye.
I got Luna's head.
You know,
I got her
somebody
head.
Who's drunk. And there's a trough full of fish, and they want to eat one, so they shoot at them until they get one.
Okay.
Promising all the damn fish and everybody else in the world.
I can imagine. Yeah. It's not pretty. Well, oh yeah, the kids. I was like, who was that? Who was the kids? It's always the kids.
Who?
The kids that were like fish in a barrel.
You and mean that, children?
Yeah.
We all are, honey.
It's true.
Would you mind setting that beside you? I'm done with it and it was delicious, honey. Thank you.
Baby.
My baby cooks the most delicious food in the world for me.
Nah, my baby cooks the most delicious food in the world. I cook sometimes. And we get fed. But,
Dobby? Okay, so here's the deal. I'm like the most exciting person in the whole damn world. Mm-hmm. Two exciting people. Mm-hmm. I'm like, my every facial movement is riveting. Not to mention, every inch of my face is riveting. Not to mention the rest of me, but we won't go there. But what I'm trying to say is my mind itself is so riveting. Isn't it? Mm-hmm. My mind's a head trip. Mm-hmm. My baby's all these same damn things. So, two people who are as amazing as we are meeting one another. What do you think's going to happen? Of course we're going to start a fucking film. Do you know that most people want to be normal? That's what I'm learning. Most people want to be normal, honey.
I'm having a hard time with this. I've been having a really hard time
with the normal thing?
With a lot of things lately. Just like the whole fucking nature of reality thing.
I don't know if there's that, but that's my point. I didn't know people really wanted to be normal. That saddens me. It deeply saddens me, but I have to respect it. People
normal's
want
overrated,
to
though.
Be
I mean,
safe and know they're going to have their bills paid. And they don't want to uproot in the middle of the night and drive cross country with the cops chasing them. But I can't understand it, can you?
Well, no, and I'm actually genuinely a little concerned with the whole ideology because...
These normal, millennials.
Because it's not... People look to... God, it's so fucking obvious. Like, you go to a party and... Yeah. I don't know, there's people dressed like... Maybe it's just too cliche, but you're gonna end up mingling with the people that are just like you.
Oh, really?
Well, yeah,
I don't ever find anybody just like me.
No,
that's my point.
That's our curse.
And that's why.
But I'm thinking about people.
But I am.
They're
I
wanting
do tend
for
to...
normalcy. They're wanting for safety. Yeah,
we
it informs,
tend to go toward people who are just
they
like
do,
us.
That, you know, the whole. I mean, my God, I don't even want to get started on
well,
it.
Well, I guess I'm trying to be compassionate and say they have a right to be normal. They have
right.
a right to live with a stable life at a damn job. And
okay,
but it just
you're
makes
right.
it harder on the rest of us, you know? It's like...
Well,
I don't get it.
I don't mean to get off course.
No,
I guess what
please
I really
stay
to
off
say
course.
Is, just the idea of normalcy. Of course, it's an illusion. There is no normal, and the idea of I think finding comfort in normalcy too much is